Generally speaking, the Park Service is really happy with all the work that's been done from year one now through year four. This is our final year. It's been a journey of learning and constant improvement and really trying to address every issue that we come across. It wasn't until we received the ARRA money that we were finally able to thoroughly address all of the issues going on within the scarp wall of Fort Jefferson to correctly stabilize this structure the way it needs to be done. So without doing the stabilization work, we are really in danger of losing significant areas of the superstructure of Fort Jefferson, which is a main feature of the Dry Tortugas National Park. It's a unaltered third system fortification in an amazing location, coupled with phenomenal natural resources. And it's really just an incredible place for people to come and spend a day and really get a nice view of what it was like in the 1870s at the Dry Tortugas.
You do your snorkeling and your zip lining, and you come back out in the same exact spot where you left me.
Wow.
Fort Jefferson is an unreinforced masonry structure, so this is entirely built out of coral concrete and bricks.
I'm a mason by trade. I've been in the trade for about 20 years. This is Fort Jefferson, the second largest masonry structure in the world. The only thing that beats this is the Great Wall of China. I've been talking about this place for 10 years to my wife. It's just really an honor to work here.
You just look out and you just see beauty everywhere you look, and it's like no other job I've ever worked on, you know. It's be having a bad day and you just turn around and look at it, and it just makes it so much better. Seeing the ocean, the sky, and all the wildlife, and pretty cool.
Well, what we have here is this is one of the original iron tot and shutter assemblies. These are impressive, massive armaments that are a key identifying historical feature of Fort Jefferson. Basically, this was armor for this opening, and inside here is a gun casemate. And every one of these openings on Fort Jefferson would have had a cannon. And the tot and shutter assembly was designed in a way that the doors would fly open as the cannon was fired, and then they would instantly recoil shut, and the pins would lock down into a locking mechanism, which would provide almost instantaneous protection for our men that were inside the gun casemate firing the guns. This was huge in order to protect our men that were firing these cannons. Over its service life, over the past 150 years, in this extreme marine environment, you can see that these iron tot and shutters have clearly expanded. They've created these massive jacking of the brick wall or the scarp wall, and this is sort of the essence of our stabilization efforts. And we need to remove these tot and shutter assemblies, and then we're going to rebuild these embrasure openings. This next embrasure is one step further along in that demolition and rebuild process. So again, here you can see all of the original shutter components have been removed. This area has been cleared off. We're prepared to rebuild an infill arch. And what you're seeing here is for tie back. So they've cut these holes in which they will actually tie back the new arch construction into this existing solid substructure that they've now gotten to. The infill arch will get reconstructed here. We will put in replicated shutter components, and then the embrasure will get reconstructed in front of that.
They were masters, you know, they were master carpenters and masons. Just the formwork to build out all these arches. You know, today, I've built many, many, many arches in this trade, but not like this, not these giant structural arches, you know, it's incredible. I learned I have a lot to learn. Well, I'd been unemployed for about 5 months. I was getting desperate. I had all my feelers out. I was looking at the paper. There was no jobs in the paper. I called every mason contractor in Miami, and I was looking at other trades to make a living. And I read an article in the paper one day about how our stimulus money has been put into action. And there was a large allotment, I believe $7 million, to restore Fort Jefferson. So I got on the computer and I searched and searched and searched. I couldn't find the contractor. So finally I contacted the National Park Service. They put me in touch with the southeastern regional office, and then they gave me the name of Enola, the contractor on this job. One of the best jobs I've ever been on in my life. It's an honor to be here.
I think it's great, you know, that putting people to work, you know, not only us bricklayers, there's other vendors that are involved, the barge operator, the people that supply our supplies from Key West, and it's not just us. There's a lot of people that are benefited from this stimulus.
One of the issues that we come across a lot of times is the amount of money that's being spent on stabilizing Fort Jefferson, and is it worth it or is it not? And I really think there is a really strong case for, yeah, it is absolutely worth it. I mean, here is this incredible structure in an incredible location that held so much historic significance on many levels. It's an amazing cultural resource, and it's coupled with some phenomenal natural resources, and it's very important that we continue this process and preserve Fort Jefferson.